إِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. And now remember the time, recall the time when the angel said, يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكُ بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنْهُ. O Maryam, verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the good tidings and the good news of a word from Him. Hazrat Masih alayhi salam, a word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ismuhul Masihu Isa ibn Maryam. His name will be Al-Masih Isa ibn Maryam, son of Maryam. Wajihan fi dunya wal akhirah. Illustrious and honorable in this world also and in the hereafter. وَمِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ. And he will be from among the nearest of him, who will be nearest to God subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazrat Masih alayhi salam will be one of them. مِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ. وَيُكَلَّمُ النَّاسُ فِي الْمَهْدِ. And he will speak to the people while in cradle. وَكَهْلًا. And also when he will be of mature age. This is very important, this kahlan word. Because as the history goes, Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wa salam was raised to heaven according to our beliefs and was crucified according to the Christian belief when he was only 33 years. And this word is not applicable to a person of a 33 years only. Quran has used this special word, kahlan. This kahul is definitely after 40 years. So Hazrat Masih alayhi salam will have an age where he will be. This word will be applicable to him in Kahlan, and that will be after his second descent, when he comes again. Second coming of Jesus alayhi salatu wassalam. This is a common creed and belief between us and the Christians. Second coming of Jesus. But the difference is that they believe that Jesus was crucified, then he was resurrected, and then he was raised to the heaven. And what we believe is that he was not at all crucified. He was raised alive to the heaven, and then both agree that he will come again. So this is a common point, and we must remember it here, and we should repeat it here in this society where you are living, that these points are common, and the only difference is we believe that he was a prophet of Allah. They believe that he was a part of deity. That's the difference. But you know, as regards the person of Jesus alayhi salatu wasalam, that he was born without a father. This is common between us and Christians. Virgin Mary, She gave birth to Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam. Then he was raised to the heaven. That is common between us and the Christians. The difference is only that they think that he was crucified, then resurrected, and then raised. We say not at all. He was not at all crucified. وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُ. The matter was become, you know, doubtful for them, was made doubtful by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then again we agree that he will return and he will come again. So these are the points which are common between Muslims and Christians. So word kahla is here very important. وَيُكَلَّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا. Although we can see that there was no need of using this word. Everybody when he is mature of age, he speaks. Why was it mentioned? Actually, speaking in the cradle was something, you know, very extraordinary. So it was mentioned. If it is very natural that it should have been mentioned. But why kahla? There was no need of saying it. The only need is that we must know that he is to come again. Because among the Muslims, so-called Muslims also, there are some people who don't give due importance to the ahadith. They have doubts about these things, which I am telling you. وَيُكَلَّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا وَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. He will be from among the righteous people. إِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَىٰ. Now, you know, especially Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Just recall when Allah will say to Isa, Ya Isa, O Isa ibn Maryam, son of Mary, uskur ni'mati alayk, just recall and remember my blessings upon you, wa ala walidatik, and upon your mother, is ayyattuka bi ruhil qudus. When I strengthened you through the Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit, tukallimu an-nasa fil mahdi wa kahla. So that you spoke to the people in the cradle as an infant. And you spoke also as an old man in old age. Now this word here is very important. Kahla. According to the history, Jesus was raised or lifted from this earth to heaven. And it is accepted by all the Christians at the age of 33. This is not kahulat.
Even at the age of 40, it is shab, according to Arabic language. Kahul, kahl means old age. This means old age will come to Hazrat Jesus, Hazrat Masih alayhi salam, when he returns to this earth, and this is given by Hadith. He will come back, then he will marry, he will have children, and then he will die. And perhaps he will remain on earth for 40 long years. So 40 plus 33 go to make 73. Now this is old age. Otherwise this word cannot be explained. Now this is a point for those who don't believe in the second coming of Jesus. There are so many people among the Muslims who don't give any importance to ahadith. And these things, you know, which appear to them to be against scientific phenomena. How can a person come again and how can a person remain alive in the heaven for 2,000 long years? Because these things are unusual. These are miraculous. Even his birth was miraculous, without father. He was given the biggest miracles, the palpable, the seen miracles, which can be seen with the eyes. The biggest miracle is Quran. But this is not something to be seen with eyes. It is to be understood through your intellect and heart. The biggest visible miracles were given to Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam. And there is a list coming. تُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا.